It is the first triple homicide in Coconino County in decades. Because of that, the sheriff has every detective in the county working this case.
It has been many, many years since we have had a triple homicide. And so certainly this one is brutal, and it is very serious, and we hope to follow it up to a successful conclusion as efficiently as we can.
In the woods of northern Arizona. After an intense investigation, the killer was never apprehended and presumed to still be on the loose. It all started out when two men decided to go camping here in these mountains.
But a bunch of people, and just sick with the earth, sick with the society.
Just tell them that too, make them move.
You got a flashlight in the car?
I think so.
You?
Alright, man. God, we gotta get out of here, dude. This sucks, man.
I can't wait, man.
Shh. Nothing but a city.
Tired people fucking with me.
I know. We gotta get out of this city, take a little vacation.
I swear, man, one more person lips off to me, I'm gonna go fucking crazy.
Jesus Christ. Every day, same old shit, same old crap. Nothing but a big rat race. That's all it is, man. Let's get out of this fucking crap. Let's go, man. Let's get out of here, dude. Can't stand the city, dude. Let's take a little break. Let's go up to the mountains.
Cowboy movie.
Oh yeah.
John Wayne.
The real rebel.
What a great
time to come in the morning. Boy, what a beautiful time to come up. This is a beautiful time.
Evidence had showed that the two men rented a boat from this dock for the day and had never returned. The boat was found later the next day, abandoned.
Arizona Fish.
Holy fuck, dude! That's a trout in the hand! Holy shit! Dude, hold it up! Hold it up! Senor! Holy fuck! That's a big trout, dude! Right, baby! We trout tonight! Right on.
Better throw that one back.
Yeah, she's big. Only problem is she swallowed the fucking major. People just suck her off and she's not even sure.
Hey, you want these things?
last seen them, and then they left for the camping trip. So it would have been that, you know, less no more. So yes, I was touched.
Were they going to borrow your boat trailer?
All along.
Did they not ask to borrow your boat trailer?
Yeah. Yeah, they did.
What was your response?
I didn't think it was a good idea. What do you mean what it was a bad response by the boat trailer?
You were mad because, they wanted to go fishing, but they didn't want to take you along.
There's no way that was true.
Were you upset?
There was no way. Because I was the one that didn't want to go on the trip with them at the time, and it was only because I was at a job making some money. That was the only reason that I didn't go.
So you didn't work that weekend?
What?
We called your employer and we said you had those 2 days off. About 5 minutes after it gets raining.
On the same weekend, there was a report that an escaped convict from a local prison had hijacked a car, killing the driver and leaving his body on the side of the road. Unknowingly picked up the prison escapee hitchhiking, and allegedly the trio had been seen camping around this area. Witnesses reported they heard screaming and shouting later that night.
What's going on?
Looks like you got it, buddy.
This guy's broken
down. Why, Lee? We'll give you a ride. Oh, we'll give you a ride into town to Circle K.
Okay.
Did you ever talk about or discuss going up north?
Yes, we did. That was the last time they were in camp. That was when I was going to go, supposed to go with them.
And did they tell you where they were going camping?
Yes, they did. In a certain area. And I already know even more. Told you that from the point of when they called me, or when I was with them the first time they went before the cabin trip, that I was there with them. So we've already established that, and that was the last time of any communication that I've had with them other than the phone call that you've asked me about, and I wasn't there for the phone call. You already know that because I was on the phone, talking to him on the phone, and he said he was scared.
He said he was scared?
Yes. He said he was scared.
Did he say what he was scared about?
Well, yeah.
Lord knows how I feel about the things I do. There's only one way to satisfy me. And there's only one way I only live. Motherfuckers don't understand. It's just me. It's the way I am. It's the way I tick. So if you fuck with me, it's the last time you ever see yourself fuck with anybody else. And that's what I have to say. Fuck y'all. Alright? Fuck y'all.
The two men notified Forest Service Rangers that an acquaintance of the suspect left hiking earlier that morning and they had found his body later that day, stabbed to death and floating face down in Woods Canyon Creek.
I don't know why we haven't seen Ed, knowing all this stuff's been going on, all this shit.
That was his name, right? Jason? I mean, this guy picked him up, you know? He was trying to help this guy out, next thing you know. Gotta get out of here.
It's pain of the punishment. It's only an inner greater pain. Consequences of our habitual wrongdoing. If we don't learn to control ourselves, eventually someone else will. Force or incarceration.
Punishment is a hint of greater pain, the consequence of our habitual wrongdoing. If we do not learn to control ourselves, eventually someone else will do it for us, either through force or incarceration.
Take a trail, dude. Let's just take this down, man. Just gotta keep walking down. You have to be up at least 10,000 feet.
It's kinda hard to fucking breathe.
Thank you.
Are you alright?
ever since I moved to this city, it's been nothing but people who don't want to say hi, people who really think that I don't like the big city. I enjoy small town people. I thought that's what we were escaping when we came. We're gonna die, you understand that? We're not gonna get out of here.
Oh my god. Oh my god. Oh my god. I can't. Oh.
Saying, dude, it's right up around here, right up around in these woods. It's where those guys took it out, chopped up something vicious. You know, I don't know much about, you know, being a good or bad soul, but all I know is there was nothing good about that. Not many people venture out this way. That cabin right there, you know, people don't get out this way much. Not after that.
Did they ever find that other body?
You know, and that's the scary thing, man, because we'll probably be some guy up here, you know, checking on his cabin in a couple years and end up taking a piss on that dude's bones, you know, man? Something. People just don't go missing. Not show up again. I mean, there's a lot of wildlife out here, but what do you do with the whole human body?
That was last summer, wasn't it?
Sure enough, and now that it's wintertime, they'll never find that dude. Buried in there. Probably forever.
After an intense search and investigation, the alleged killer was never apprehended, and locals say he's so all I have got to say is, be careful out there when you're camping here in these woods. This is Rainey Smaglia reporting from Payson, Arizona.
Of greater pain.
that is the consequence of habitual wrongdoing. If we do not learn how to control ourselves, eventually, someone else will do it for us, through force or incarceration.